I'm Kimberly Arusha, Managing Director of the USGA Green Section. I'd like to welcome you to another installment in the USGA Webcast series. These presentations summarize ideas and procedures observed by the USGA agronomists as they visit golf courses throughout North America. The Green Section is not suggesting that the methods depicted are the best or only means of performing a particular task. Our goal is to share a broad variety of management techniques for the benefit of golf courses.
Hello, I'm Bud White, Director of the Mid-Continent Region, the USGA Green Section. We're going to talk about actually using the lightweight fairway mowers as grooming units in addition to simply cutting units. Many years ago, the fairways were completely mown with tractor-drawn large gang mowers, and so it was impossible to stripe or diagonal cut fairways with these large units. Now we have the lighter fairway units, and their maneuverability and flexibility is quite significant. We are able to burn in, which has become the standard term, stripes in fairways, but this can lead to problems, especially in grasses that are creeping in nature, such as Bermuda grass, zoysia grass, or bent grass, versus more upright turfs such as bluegrass or ryegrass. Here's an example of the old type of tractor unit, and to be able to groom fairways with this unit, the only means to accomplish this was to do what is known as circle cutting. This is simply mowing the fairway in a circular motion, going down one side of the fairway, back up the other, and then down the middle again to complete the coverage of the fairway. These circles were usually about 50 feet in diameter with this larger unit, and this changed the direction of the mowing, which allowed some grooming features to be accomplished. We're going to discuss cross cutting of fairways as well as circle cutting to use the fairway mowers as a grooming tool and to offset the tendency for grain accumulation. These videos that you will soon see were filmed at Miramont Country Club in Bryan, Texas, where John Snyder is superintendent. As I said, mowing fairways in a striping pattern is beautiful and has become very popular throughout the industry, but burning in these stripes and not changing direction can be very detrimental to the quality and uniformity of the playing surfaces from a tremendous amount of grain being developed from continuous mowing in one direction. We understand this concept by our change of direction, of course, with greens. Here's an example of how significant striping can be, as this is a dormant Bermuda grass fairway, and yet the striping of continuous same direction mowing is quite significant even during the dormancy. Vertical mowing in fairways is an excellent way of not only promoting better turf health with creeping type of grasses, but also to deal with the tendency for grain accumulation and thatch accumulation. Many golf courses cannot afford to do this extensive a cultural program on fairways, and therefore utilizing direct cross 90 degree cross cutting as well as circle cutting with the lightweight fairway mowers offers an alternative for modest budget courses that is feasible for helping with grain management. You are seeing a direct 90 degree cross cut operation carried out with the fairway mowers, and the suggestion for this is to do this approximately once per week in the growing season for the change of direction management and consequently grain management. This is the circle cutting program that is being carried out on this fairway, and my recommendation has been to alternate circle cutting with cross cutting, and each are done once per week on an alternating week basis during the growing season. You will notice that in this video you see the operator making about 20 to 22 feet in diameter circle mowing patterns as he progresses down the fairway. I suggest that as this is utilized multiple times during the growing season, that the operator goes in a clockwise direction one time and counterclockwise the next, so as to maximize the grooming effects. Would also suggest that the first 1 to 2 mowings with circle cutting, that the fairway units be raised approximately 10% so that you can evaluate the tendency for scalping. The amount of scalping will vary according to how much thatch is present and how much grain in the fairways. In summary, the fairway mower can be used quite efficiently as a grooming tool. And again, this is most beneficial for any golf course, but is especially beneficial on more modest budget golf courses that can't do other detailed operations such as deep vertical mowing. The 90 degree cross cutting regularly is an excellent tool, but circle cutting offers an even more aggressive means of grooming fairways and combating grain, especially when used in alternated weeks during the growing season. Again, I would suggest with the first circle cut to set the mower about 10% higher to monitor the tendency for scalping. I hope that this discussion and videos of cross-cutting and direct cross-cutting will be of use to you at your course in offering a reasonable cost alternative to additional grooming and grain management in fairways.
This has been another installment in the USGA webcast series. For more information on golf course management, visit www.usga.org and click on the Course Care tab.